Hello friends, welcome back to my channel. This is Swapna here. Hope you all are doing well. Today we are going to create this beautiful wall decor with an African lady silhouette. I'm using a glass painting technique here, however I'm not painting on a glass. I've used an OHB sheet for the painting. I usually prefer using Pebeo glass liners for my glass paintings, but since I need a really thick outline here, I prefer to use this 3D liner. All the details about these paints and the liner will be mentioned in the description below. Now I'm drawing all the outlines evenly. Since I'm using OHB sheets, I can easily move around this painting according to the direction of my liner. So these days I prefer using plexiglass, which is perspex, or OHB sheets for my painting because they are really lightweight and easy to handle and also unbreakable. So the shipment of the artworks or even the storage of these artworks are really easier. Make sure that the finger pressure on the liner body is consistent so that you get a uniform lines. This liner usually takes a bit longer time to dry up compared to Pebeo glass liners. Now I have completed all the lining works and I'm noticing this portion unfinished, so I've just completed all the lining works. Unfortunately, after finishing all the lining works, I noticed that the frame that I'm planning to use for this painting is slightly smaller than the real OHB sheet that I've taken, so I've decided to cut the small portion. Now I'm beginning with the painting part. This is a really easy and simple painting, so I've restricted my color usage. I'm just using 3 shades for this painting and I'll be using Fevicryl water-based glass paints for this. I usually use Pebeo vitriol paints for most of my projects because it's readily available here and there are lots of color options in Pebeo. This was a requested video to show how to use a Fevicryl basic set for beginners. I like these paints because the paint is pigmented well and also the nozzle makes the work easier and gives a consistent layer of paint on the painting. Now I'm thinking of adding few more details in certain portions. So with the Pebeo golden glass liner, I'm just adding few details. You can notice the difference of thickness of the line when I'm using the Pebeo liner. This liner will dry quickly, so meanwhile I'll add other colors in different portions. If there is any bubbles in certain portions, you can just dab it with a tissue. For the black portion, I need a really opaque one, so I'm using the shade from Glass Art. Since it's a solvent-based paint, I prefer applying it with a toothpick. For certain paintings, I use my brushes also, but the cleaning of brushes will be a bit difficult when it is solvent-based paints. Now this golden liner is already dried and I'm starting to apply paint in those portions. Now our painting part is completely finished and I'm moving on to adding some details. Ideally, you should wait until the painting is thoroughly dried and then start adding the details. But here I am filling the liner in portions where I have not painted, and also my daylight is going down, so I thought of adding the textures already. Glass liners add really gorgeous textures on our painting. Here I am adding few dots as well as lines. You can use the liner according to your choice, I mean the texture as well as the shade of the liner. I think I need to add a bit more texture in the turban side. Here the painting is completely finished. I'm letting it dry thoroughly and then I'm moving on to framing this one. For that I'm using a ready-made frame which I've already bought from Homecentre and is of size 5x7. I'll add the details in the description. This is a burlap cloth which I've bought as a roll and that will be used as a background. While framing, first I'll keep my painting's front side facing downwards and then I'll keep the burlap cloth as a background and then we get our beautiful wall decor piece. I hope you all enjoyed watching this video. If you did, please don't forget to like, comment and share this video. And if you're new to my channel, please don't forget to subscribe the channel and press the bell icon for more interesting arts and crafts videos. Thank you.